Tullahoma, Tennessee be like what COVID-19? Well, we all know the key to starting out a good day of rail fanning is a good, good breakfast.
Hello, I can help you.
Yes, ma'am. Can I get 2 triple cheeseburgers, please?
Okay, what else for you?
That'll be it. This is the hillsides around Lynchburg, Tennessee. The famous home of Jack Daniels. We're gonna see the distillery in this video. We ain't gonna go in because you ain't going in nothing around here right now. But you guys are at least gonna see where Jack Daniels whiskey is made here in just a second. This is a 2-lane road. This is Highway 55. Here at the red light. This is the only red light in Lynchburg. Going around the square in Lynchburg. Normally this place is like hustling and bustling, but it's just weird to see it like this. I would recommend, if y'all ever venture down my way one day, of course I'm always going to say stop in Cowan, come see us at the Railroad Museum when we get back open. But, you know, venture a little ways out over here. Come see Lynchburg, especially the Dixie Outfitter out there. Good man runs that place. And the barbecue restaurant right beside it is awesome. And right here, this darker brick building right here is the Lynchburg General Store. Jack Daniels. All this area over here, this is where the distillery is. It's not open to pull in there, or I would.
I also didn't account on the distillery not maintaining the trees and stuff, so you really didn't get to see anything. Instead of going to Normandy, we decided just to go to Wartrace. There was nothing interesting going on in Normandy. Our first train of the day in Wartrace would be Q581. Daily mixed traffic from Radnor Yard in Nashville, Tennessee to Greenwood, South Carolina. If you're wondering why he's going so slow, he's currently running on an approach signal, getting ready to stop. Our next train would be Q582. Q582 is daily mixed freight and started in Hamlet, North Carolina, and was roughly an hour from ending its journey in Nashville, Tennessee. Q581 and Q582 would end up doing a walking meeting directly at the crossing in the middle of Wartrace, Tennessee. I believe this is one of the coolest shots I've ever gotten.
got the 6100 and left that other engine for them to use. Now they got you to get it.
Yeah, that's right. We had to pick up 5 cars and that engine down there a while ago. We shuffled through there and got it in, you know. It said that you couldn't use a, couldn't use the brakes and all, but we did and it worked. And we went on and done that and brought it on out. I don't know what they're going to do with it.
Yeah, we left that little 6100 swapped it over to yard job yesterday at Ratner there.
I'm sure they got a plan on this, and I just don't know what it is yet.
They know they got you for 12.
Hey, that's all right. I'll take it. I ain't complaining.
Here you go.
We would chase Q581 from Wartrace about 25 minutes down the road to Tullahoma, Tennessee, and set up just in time to catch him battling up 7 Mile Hill. Ironic thing is, the engineer at Q581 has given me more horn shows in any of my videos than anyone else I've taught. Next day in Cowan, our first train would be Q580, Greenwood, South Carolina mixed freight that had to pick up and set off in DeLuca, Georgia and Chattanooga, Tennessee on its journey to Nashville. I also want to take this time to thank all 104 of my subscribers for helping me grow this channel. If you'll just hang along with me, we can get through this drought and freight traffic. Let's just keep this thing going. Once again, thank you guys. We would end day two with a rare sight that isn't becoming so rare anymore, M780. M780 is the Tullahoma local coming through Cowan, Tennessee on its way to Bridgeport, Alabama to drop off and work the limestone plant in Anderson, Tennessee. M780 would also need a push returning after working Anderson, but unfortunately, I did not get to catch that move. Well, guys, that's all I got for today. Hope you enjoyed.